All right, here we are back again with a another repair video. This time on a 1952, I believe, Westinghouse clock radio. And got a bag of parts from Axeman and some parts that I found around. And, well, here we go. Just simple AA5. There are 6 capacitors when you include the 2 that are in the filter. I already removed one of them. This is why they don't use these anymore. That was such a huge explosion when that happened. It wasn't in my ownership when that happened. But look at how charred all of this is. It's just totally black over here where it happened. And these wires are just covered in soot from that explosion. Look at that. Isn't that crazy? But yeah, that's that. I guess I'll replace that one first. That'll probably be the toughest one to fix. And then move on from there. Well, this is weird. It seems like my soldering iron has become hot. And I don't mean physically hot. I mean electrically hot, because I was soldering, and then I touched the side here, and I was holding on to the chassis down here, and it shocked me. It wasn't like full line voltage shock, but it was like a shock that it felt like when you accidentally touch a spark plug or something while the engine's running. It was really bizarre, but whatever. I guess I'll just have to be more careful with this thing, or else try to fix that or replace something. Huh. Check this thing out. Looks like it got pretty hot. Pyramid. Huh. Well, that's all said and done. Don't mind all the electrical tape here. That's just because I don't want any wires grounding out in weird ways. Don't worry, everything's soldered reliably with J-hooks and whatnot. We're all good. Anyways, I guess it's time for the most thrilling part, which is plugging it in and testing it out. Alright, ready to see a Westinghouse explode? I'm not. Oh, here goes nothing. Oh wait, shoot, I forgot a tube. Alright, now here we go. Hear the clock, 16 watts, 18 watts.
And we need the Indiana Bills, both of us being Big Ten guys. I've been watching.
Let's see if that works. Awesome. Needs to be dusted. But it works. Look at that thing. Look at how 1950s that is. Everything about it. This font down here, the font on the clock, drawing 25.2 watts, perfect. Sounds like the speaker needs a little help. I can hear it rattling, but that just might be something else. Because this thing isn't screwed together right now.
In Texas, this game right now is 3-0.
Well, that's falling in there because it's not screwed in. Anyways, that seems to work great. Awesome. kudos to you, Westinghouse. You build something that's repairable, at least back then. It looks like it was sitting in a barn for a long time. There's a lot of just, like, hay and grass. Oh, wow, check that out. That's a different... It's actually not part of the full plastic mold. But yeah, there's a lot of, like, grass and just dust and hay and farm crap. Hopefully not actual crap. But anyways, I'd say that it works. Awesome. That was a quick little repair video, I guess, on an old school 1952 Westinghouse All-American 5 vacuum tube clock radio. Thank you for watching.